Hello everyone. So today's topic is Amazon S3. As I already said, I'll be providing details in depth about each and every features present in AWS. So S3, what it stands for? It stands for Simple Storage Service, as I already mentioned in the slide. S3, it is as old as AWS. Means you can say you can compare the age of AWS and S3. Those are pretty same, and so it is a very important topic for you to cover in solution architect exam. So what is S3? Simple storage service. What are the features? It provides developers and IT teams with secure, durable, highly scalable object storage. Amazon S3 is easy to use with a simple web services interface. I will show you in the lab section how to do it. And retrieve a simple web services and retrieve any amount of data from anywhere on the web. It is very safe place to store your files. It is object-based storage. What does this object-based storage means? Means where you are going to store your pictures, Word files, videos, etc. It is not somewhere where you install OS or database or applications. If you are installing OS database application, then it won't be object-based storage. It will be block-based storage. The data is spread across multiple devices and facilities. So let's go ahead with the basics of S3. Well, Amazon S3 is object-based storage and allows you to upload files, as I already said. Files can be from 0 bytes to 5 TB. There is unlimited storage, but you need to pay per gigabytes. S3 is files are stored in buckets. So we will be wondering, what is a bucket? Here bucket, you can compare it as a folder in Windows. So here bucket is folder in the cloud, as a folder in the Windows. So here bucket is a folder in the cloud. What makes it a bucket is, instead of a folder, it has a universal namespace. Means if I'm taking a bucket, let's say of the name InfraDBA, I cannot create another bucket with the same name. If someone else has taken my name InfraDBA, so I cannot take that name again. So names must be unique globally. Why is it so? Because these buckets, they generate a domain name, and if the domain name is already taken, then you won't be able to set up that bucket. So HTTPS S3 hyphen the EU hyphen West 1, that is the region name, .amazon.com, amazonaws.com and /bucket name. This is the site. Means this should be the link for AWS. This can be asked in your questions. And whenever you upload a file in S3, you will receive a HTTP 200 code if the upload is successful. There are many more things of S3. It is built for 99.99% availability. Amazon guarantees you 99.9999, means you can remember 11 nines durability for S3 information. Means if you upload a file in S3, Amazon gives you 11 nines durability, that you won't lose that file. You can compare it as 100% itself. Tiered storage is available. Life cycle management is there. Versioning control is there. You can control a version of a file. In lifecycle management means if a file is 30 days old, you can move from one storage to another or even archive it. Encryption is there. You can secure your data using access control lists and bucket policies. Access control list means you can secure a single, I mean, so you can give a permission for a single file data as to whether you should make it public, you should make it private, whether you should block any IP address. And bucket policies is for the whole bucket. So what is a data consistency model of S3? S3, it is, you can, as you can see in the slide, it is read after write consistency for puts of new objects, eventual consistency for overwrite puts and deletes. So what is read after write consistency for puts of new objects? Let's imagine if we text a file and say hello infra DBA, and we upload that to our S3 bucket, we go to read that file immediately after upload. We'll be able to read the contents of that file. And in eventual consistency, let's say hello infra DBA, we are updating that file hello infra DBA exclamation mark. At that time, if we went to read on that file immediately, we can get two results. One is just the old version of the file, which is hello infra DBA, or we can get the new version also, which is hello infra DBA exclamation mark. So eventually it takes that new file, but can take time to propagate. So what is S3? Is a simple key value store. So as I already said, it's a object based. So what does that object consist of? Key. This is nothing but the name of the object, the file, the image you are storing in that name of the image, that is key. Value is nothing but the data which is made up of sequence of bytes. Means you are keeping a text file. The text file name is infra DBA.txt. That infra DBA.txt, that is the key. And if you double click on the infra DBA.txt, you will be getting some more files, some datas in it. That is the value. Version ID, that is important for versioning. Metadata, that data you are storing about data, that is metadata. Sub resources, those are access control links, torrent. Torrent won't be covered because it is not much important. So what are the S3 storage tiers or classes? S3 standard. First is S3 standard. This has 99.99% availability, 11 nines durability, stored redundantly across multiple facilities, and is designed to sustain the loss of two facilities concurrently. So multiple devices, what is this multiple devices here? Multiple devices means multiple disks, and multiple facilities means multiple availability zones. There is no retrieval fee in standard. Next is S3 IA. IA is infrequently accessed. This is for data that is accessed less frequently but requires rapid access when needed. This has a lower fee than S3, but you are charged for the retrieval fee. S3 one zone IA, this is same as S3 IA, but it won't have multiple availability zone data resilience. This is much more lower cost. Next is Glacier. Glacier is the cheapest of all. It is used for data archival only. Means data you won't access at all for those. There are three different models. That one is expedited. This will be done as soon as possible. Standard retrieval, standard, and under this bulk. So expedited retrieval, it won't take much time. Standard retrieval takes around 3 to 4 hours, and bulk retrieval it takes around 12 hours or more. In this chart, you can see design for durability, all are 11 lines. Design for availability, so if you need availability, this one is much more secure, S3 standard. Then we go ahead with S3 IA, then one zone IA, and then ratio. Availability SLA, in for availability SLA also, as you see, design for availability, like that, as availability of SLA for S3 standard is much more, pretty much more than this. Availability zones greater than equal to 3. Minimum capacity per object, minimum storage, you can check this, I believe you won't be having any problem in getting what is this. So what are the, so we can go ahead with the S3 charges. So what are the, for what all S3 is charged? First of all is storage. Storage, it is charged per gigabyte, per GB basis. Request, this is for the number of requests that are made to the object to view the object or update object, anything. Storage management pricing, when you upload a file and tag it to assume, let's say HR department. Data transfer policy, pricing it should be. The transfer data from one region to other. Transfer acceleration. This is a what is transfer acceleration? This is a fast and secure way of transferring over long distances between end users and S3 buckets. It takes advantage of CloudFront's globally distributed edge locations. As the data arrives at an edge location, data is routed onto Amazon S3 over an optimized network path. So this is all about S3. So let's go ahead first and let's create a bucket, S3 bucket, so that we can get to know more of S3. So I'm in the AWS console. Here you can see my region is Mumbai. So from where should I go to S3? See, you can see I recently visited S3 and EC2. So these are there in the recently visited services. But from where should we get it? Well, let's go to services. Let's go to storage. In storage, we have S3, S3 Glacier, Storage Gateway, AWS Backup, EFS, FSx. Let's go to S3. S3 buckets. See, as I entered to S3, you can see my region changed to global, and if I want also, I cannot change it to Mumbai, because you can see here S3 does not require region selection. So what should be my next? As you can see here, by default are managed globally, does not require any region selection. Let's create a bucket. So I went to here, I don't have any buckets present right now. So this should be, bucket name should be DNS compliant. Let me give my bucket name as InfraDB. See, bucket name must not contain uppercase characters. Bucket name must start with a lowercase letter or number. So I gave here InfraDBA, infra as I as caps, so it won't take. I can just create from here, but let's go ahead with next and show you what all are the other things. Versioning is there, keep all versions of an object in the same bucket. Log request, server access login is there, log request for this. You can mention the tag. Let me mention the tag as let's say InfraDBA like this, something like department, HR department and all. And I will keep these blah 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 blah, this all as default, and give next. This is highly recommended, means by default it is clicked so that these are not public and not publicly accessible. And let's go ahead and create it now. So let's create this bucket, and my bucket is created. Let's try again and create one more bucket with the same name. As I said, bucket name is already owned by you, so it is not about me. If someone else also creates it, I won't be able to see. Let us take an example of the highly famous Cloud Gurus. Let me see whether Cloud Guru is there or not. Oh, it is there. So I'm not sure which bucket they are using. A Cloud Guru, no, that is also there. Okay, the name was A Cloud Guru, but once I am probably my net was slow or not, I don't know. Once I clicked on next, it didn't take. See, A Cloud Guru already exists. I'm not sure whether this has been used by Cloud Guru's site or itself or something else. As you can see here, if you click on, if you put your cursor in information, this thing, the bucket name must be unique across all existing bucket names in Amazon S3. Bucket names, buckets used as an origin point of for cloud, Amazon cloud CloudFront distribution have specific restrictions. So here is our bucket which we created just now. Buckets and objects not public, you can see in the access. So this is not a public. As I said, by default all buckets are private. So let's go ahead and click in here. See, I don't have anything in my bucket, and so my bucket is empty. So we can upload it from here, but before that, let's check on the properties. Sorry, I got a call. So we went to properties. You can see the version in, you can enable the, you can change anything, any properties you want from here afterwards. You can change the version in of the files, server access login, static website hosting, those will be done later on in the course, to make this a static website by giving a HTML file, object level login, you can encrypt your objects stored in the S3. You can prevent objects from getting deleted by creating an object log. Tags, right now one tag is present. Transfer acceleration, this will be taken care. Events, requester page, if you are if anyone is accessing your S3, so they need to pay for the data they request. So let's go ahead with permissions. These are public settings. Access control is for controlling each and every, means you can set permissions for each and every object in here. Bucket policy, you can go ahead for the entire bucket. Cross origin resource sharing, this configuration also will be taken care afterwards in the latter part, or in the next, in my next video, or probably in this video itself, I'll take care of it. And then management, here we have lifecycle management, replication, cross-region replication, analytics, metrics, inventory. So now let's go ahead and upload a file in here. So let's go ahead and put some files in this bucket. Upload from here. Let's add the file. I've kept two files in here. So if you go in here, you can see Doctor Strange and this one. I'm giving these two files. Next, You can just upload it, and or else if you want to check each and every field, you can go ahead, manage public permissions, access for other AWS accounts. You can give the, you can add the account. So right now I'm the owner. I'm having objects read permission and object permissions as read write. I'll go ahead with the standard version of the frequently asked questions. You can have integer triarin, IA, Glacier. Encryption if you want, metadata if you want, tag if you want, you can put. So we have two files. This is a summary. We have two files of this permissions, one grantees, properties, these things, and just uploaded. So this is uploaded. So right now if you click in here in this one, you will get these details. You will get the expiration date, the size of the this last modified, where it is been stored, in which storage class, if whether encryption is there or not, what metadata, if any tags are there or not, these things you will be, the permissions you will get. So I just clicked on the link. Let me show you again. I am just clicking on the link to open this file, and what it is saying, it gives an error. Why is it so? Because as I said earlier itself, all file means in by default all objects in the file are private. So if I want, means it was an easy option for me to change from here, make public. But you can see operations, one error, 100% failed. So what we need to do in here then? Edit it, as you can see permissions, and let's untick this and save. Confirm, we need to confirm it. And it's been saved. So let me go back once. Objects. So if right now if you can see, objects can be public, it's showing in here, but it does not mean that all the objects are public. So right now we need to change it from here. We need to go here, make public. Right now one success. So this file has been changed. You will get a HTTP 200 once you. So if you click in here and if you go to the link, right now it's working. So Mr. Doctor Strange has arrived. Okay, just I'm just cut short in the video till here, since if you go ahead, means it will be a very big video for all of you to, and you won't be having that much of patience to go ahead. So I'm just cut short in the video in till here, and next thing we'll go ahead with is from version control lab. We'll be having a version control lab. What is MFA delete, cross region replication, lifecycle management, CloudFront. These topics and many more topics, those will be taken care in the next in one of my next videos. So stay tuned and subscribe so that you receive all the notifications. Thank you.